See, we are talking about the thing called as greedy method, right? We are going to talk about this entire session is all about figuring out the greedy method. Okay, I think I muted myself, sorry. Okay, so just going to come back. See, we are talking about a very important strategy called as greedy method. Okay, now in this greedy method, what becomes very important? Okay, what becomes very important is the definition of it, of course. But before going into the definition part of it, we need to figure out what is this cashier's problem. Okay, what is the cashier's problem? You can see these are the number of denominations of the coins that are given. What is the number of coins you have? 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. So there are 5 1 paisa coins. Then there is 2 5 paisa coins. Then there are 2 10 paisa coins, and of course there is 1 25 paisa coins. Okay, now you can see these are the coins that are given. Now the cashier wants to have a 32 paisa change to be given. He wants you to give a 32 paisa change. So what he wants to do? Obviously, he wants to keep maximum change for himself, just like cashier, just like what you call classic a bus conductor does. Okay. They want to keep the maximum change for themselves because to give for the next few customers. So if with minimum number of coins, he wants to give you the 32 paisa. Is that possible? Yes, it is possible. How? He can give 25 paisa, 5 paisa, 30, 1, 2, 32 paisa. Now you can see very clearly with minimum number of coins, he gave the solution of 32 paisa to you without any problem. Okay. This thing that you got to see here is something to be kept in mind because we are going to come back to here later. Okay, now again, let's take one more example. Now, this is for those people who may be thinking whether greedy method will be giving you the best optimal solution every time. No, it's not going to give that. Let's take one more solution. Okay, let's again take the cashier's problem. 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. So, how many? One, I'll write. I'll write 5 ones. Then I'll go with 10, 10, 15. So these are the number of coins you have. I'll always write it as paisa coins. Okay. Now, again, the problem. The problem is the cashier wants to give a change of 20 paisa. 20 paisa change needs to be given. Now, you know in the previous instances that you got to know that you was always going to give the maximum. You are going to first choose the maximum denomination or the maximum paisa that you have. That people going to choose first maximum denomination. Then they'll go for the next terms. Then they'll go for the next maximum to figure out to give the solution for it. Okay, to give a solution for it. Now, based on this strategy, what will happen? People will be going with obviously the 15. First thing is, first they are going to select the 15 paisa. Then you can see he wants to give only 10, 20 paisa. So he can't choose 10 and 10 here. So obviously, what he'll do? He'll go with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So he'll choose all this 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, all this 1 paisa. Then he'll be able to give that 20 paisa to you. But this, whatever you saw, is not an optimal solution. Why you call it as not an optimal solution? Because of a very simple reason. You can give that entire 20 paisa change just by doing two things. What are the two things you can do? Take 10 paisa and one more 10 paisa, you can give that 20 paisa change. But this strategy, what is this strategy? Choosing the maximum denomination followed by the next maximum denomination. It worked in this example. You can see it worked really well in this example. What was the minimum? See, you took the maximum thing, then again the next thing. Okay, of course, not. I didn't take 10 because it will go past 32. I took 5, one minimum transactions. I did that. But here it is not working. Okay, in this method, it is not at all working fine. So what I can say that this method, what is this method? This method is called greedy method. Okay, may not give you optimum solution every time. So now whatever I'm going to talk, this becomes very important. because you're going to write this as an, you know, what you call answer when the question is asked. A greedy algorithm tries to find the best solution for each sub problem. Be careful with the words I'm using. Okay, so there is a greedy method will always try to figure out the best solution for each sub problem. Each sub problem, we are going to figure out the best solution, best possible solution. Why? With the hopes that this will give the best solution to the final problem or the whole problem. Final or the whole problem. Which basically means, see, instead of dividing it, instead of decreasing it, the subproblems will try to figure out the best solution for it. So when you combine all the subproblems, then obviously you are going to get the best solution for a greedy method. Okay. This greedy method is quite simple. It's straightforward and easy to invent, easy to implement, sometimes very much efficient. Okay, but a greedy algorithm makes the best choice that looks the best at the moment. At the moment, whichever is the best choice that it will use. This short-sightedness, see, I'm talking about both advantages and disadvantages, be careful. This short-sightedness in the approach will do what? It will be making sure that this greedy method is not always the best solution. The example what you saw. Okay. So what are certain properties that you are going to come with it? This is very important. Next, explain greedy method or define greedy method. And then the follow-up things, right? What are the follow-up things? The follow-up things is first one. It is feasible. Okay. It is feasible. So what is the meaning of feasible? It satisfies the. Okay, it satisfies the whatever the problems constraints. What was the constraints in the example? First example you saw, the constraints wants to give you that 32 paisa, you know, change. So it's satisfying the problems constraints. It does it. It is locally optimal. What is the meaning of locally optimal? Be careful. I'm not talking about the world called optimal. I'm talking about locally optimal. It's a best choice, best local choice. Okay, best local choice among all the feasible choices available. What was the, you know, example that you took? The example one that selected 25 paisa. Okay, and in the second example that selected 15 paisa. 15 paisa and 25 paisa, the maximum things that selected. Okay, that is the locally optimal solution that you can have. Then the next thing, okay, it is be careful with the way I'm writing it, irrevocable. What is irrevocable? Once choice is made, you can't take it back. How? See, once you select 25 paisa, you can't again select 25 paisa here. Okay, making it, you know, easier to do it and all. No, once it's taken, it's taken. Once a choice is made, it should not be changed in the subsequent steps. Okay, that is thing with regard to this greedy method. Something which you need to know. Okay, few small things, but very, very important. This method, again, this module, again, I'm saying is quite simple. Okay, it's quite simple. In fact, if you go with an entire question paper, I'll always go with question number, you know, 5 or 6, sorry. Why 5 or 6? Because that will be representing your module 3. Two reasons, basically. Questions are straightforward. And number two, the way of doing these questions or dealing with these questions is also straightforward. Problem will be there, you're going to solve it. No time complexities, that is, you know, worrying about too much into time complexity, okay, too much into diagrams, all those things, no. Lots of mathematical things. No, yesterday, I don't know, people who attended a lab and all, not yesterday, the first two labs, whatever you saw. I was talking about so many, you know, graph-based problems, right? I was talking about Dijkstra's, Floyd's, Prim's, Kruskal's. All those things will come here. Okay? All those things will come here and all those things will be like, just like how you solve the know the previous things, okay, especially with regard to decrease and conquer, the source removal method, similar to that only it will be there. All will be graph-based problems. So it's quite forward, quite easy. Okay, so let's, you know, sort of move into the next part of it. So you probably understood what is greedy method. Okay, I'm not, you know, giving the entire theory part. I'm not going to write there itself. Okay, just go with the, you know, whiteboard. Anyway, the notes will be there. You can always read and buy it. But understanding things becomes very important because this is a core subject. This is one of a subject that forms a syllabus for your GATE exams, for your technical rounds and all. Data structures, then the continuing part of it, the design and analysis of algorithms, your discrete mathematical structures, okay, probably C program, maybe some parts of your, you know, mathematics, all these things form a syllabus for your GATE exam. So some things to be kept in mind, okay, without any, you know, forgetting all those things. Okay, so let's go for the next part. Now, what is the next part? Next part is you need to use this greedy method to figure out few things. What are the few things that you need to figure out? The first part in the syllabus, whatever they have given is the Cassius problem. Okay, the Cassius problem, and you need to figure out this one small, simple example which you need to take. You already saw now, but if you give us something, a problem like this, okay, they're going to give the same old denominations problem, Cassius denominations problem, Cassius problem, change making problem, coins change problem, all these things are same. Okay, all these things are same. Now you should take, you know, a denominations like this 1, 5, 10, 25, and probably say 100, a very big number. Okay, this is the thing what you took, and an example of what you have taken. Now, the thing that you got to keep in mind here is, okay, even with the repetitions of the coins, even with the repetitions of the coins, you need to figure out a total denominations of 30 paisa. A total denomination of 30 paisa needs to be sort of figured out. You do one thing, you repeat coins also, no problem for me. But you find out which is the best solution. But how do you find out the best? How do you make out whether something is best solution? It should have, be careful here, this is very important, it should have minimum number of coins. Or in very simple terms, I can say, it should have minimum number of transactions. With minimum number of transactions, can I be able to figure out what is known as the coin problem, or to get a solution of 30 paisa? What are the solutions that you can have? I told you very clearly that you can use what is known as a repetition of coins. The first thing I'll do, the first solution I'll do is, I'll take three coins that are 10 denominations. And I'll get 30 paisa. Be careful here, the way I'm writing it, 10, 10, 10. Okay, be careful. Is that right? Yes. Next, I'll take another solution. I'll take one coin of 25 paisa. Okay. Plus one coin, sorry, five coins of 1 paisa. Be careful with the way I'm writing, because there's some small change I'll make, you know, in this, which you need to understand. Okay, this also comes up to also around 30. And what is the number of coins you take? I took 25 coins, one coin. Then I took 5 coins of 1 paisa. Okay, so can you make out this? I'll write here also, what is the number of coins on all? Okay, here you got 3 coins, right? And here you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You got 6 coins. I'll take the third option. Third option is very simple. I take 6 coins of 5. That also again comes up to around 30. And what is the number of things that you have? You got your 5, 5, 5. So 6 coins I took like this. What is the number of, you know, the coins or transactions I have? Again 6. Okay, now the next part. This got to be kept, you know, very important. I'll take one coin of 25 paisa denomination plus one coin of 5 paisa denomination. I'll get again 30. And what is the number of coins I have taken? I have taken, be careful, 125 paisa coin and of course 1 5 paisa coin. And what is the number of, you know, coins I have used? Now you tell me, among all these things, okay, just by looking at it, all the solutions fetch you 30 only. There's no doubt in that. Among all these things, which is the one which is taking minimum number of coins or minimum number of transactions? That one will be with regard to the fourth example. Okay, this is the example that will be fetching you the best solution. Okay, when I say best solution, it clearly means that I have got the entire 30 paisa with only 2 coins without any problem. Okay, this is something that you got to keep in mind. Okay, this is the first thing that you got to keep in mind. Okay, especially with regard to the aspects of what? Greedy method, change, coin change problem. They call it from various names. Coin change problem, cashier's problem, change giving problems, whatever they ask, you should be able to sort of explain this. Take one example, you need to be able to explain that. Or they themselves are they're going to give you the denominations, you should be able to write for a best solution or an optimal solution. Okay, common sense dictates that you need to take the minimum number of coins, not just common sense, the definition of greedy method dictates that you need to take a minimum number of coins or transactions to figure out what is the solution for this. Okay, now, is that a only, you know, the example for it? No, a few examples like that which you need to sort of study. The next one, okay, the next one we got to keep in mind here is, okay, is known as knapsack problem. What is knapsack problem? Probably you would have heard of knapsack maybe in your data structures. Probably when you learned data structures problem, you would have come across what is known as a knapsack problem. Okay, so what is this knapsack problem and how does it work, all those things and all. Okay, that's very important, right? So the knapsack problem, write this. There's a knapsack problem. Okay, this is again one of an example with regard to a greedy method. So what does it say? It says given a set of items, each item will be having a mass or a value, something like that. Okay, we need to determine the number of each item to include in a collection so that the total weight is less than or equal to a given limit. Okay, so where, you know, the you will not get to know this. Once we start solving the problem, you will get to know. Where are you going to use this problem? We generally use this knapsack problem to solve that 0-1 knapsack problem, which, you know, which is one of the most widely used combinatorial optimization algorithms. What is that? It uses the concepts of combinations to figure out which is the best optimal algorithm. Okay. To use to capture the customer values and discrete characteristics of loads and all that. You don't have to worry. We're going to look into that problem also. Okay. What is our objective? Objective is to maximize the customer values with a given supply capacity on them. Okay. But to figure out that, okay, to figure out that, first we need to know what is a knapsack problem. How does it come? How does it go and all, right? So, for that, what we are going to do? Okay, we are going to take one. Obviously, we are going to take one example and then we are going to figure out how it needs to be done and all. There are two ways of doing it. One is a regular knapsack problem and of course, other one is a 0-1 knapsack problem. Okay, so both the things we'll try to figure out with regard to, you know, how it is all done, where you are going to solve it, all those things and all. Okay, and it's a very, very important thing because this entire thing of whatever you're going to see, it is going to come in form of your program also. But of course, using dynamic program, it will come. But here we are going to study in terms of greedy method.